We are continuing to follow the very latest on that catastrophic condo collapse there in Surfside, Florida. More than 3 days later, hope is dwindling to find survivors in the rubble as the death toll slowly starts to rise. During a press conference Saturday, officials confirmed now at least 5 people have died. A newly released report revealing the building was slowly sinking for decades. An engineering report outlined the details dating back to 2018. Officials say the report clearly noted structural concerns about the building. The unanswered question this morning, how did all this happen? NBC's Sam Brock reports from Miami.
Urgent hours for desperate families as round-the-clock efforts to find more than 150 people unaccounted for run into more roadblocks.
They've been fighting these fires all night. The stench is very, very thick.
Plumes of smoke coming from a fire in the belly of the rubble as teams use infrared technology to try and locate it.
It's very difficult to walk. It's very difficult to see. You don't know where the debris is.
While conditions cleared a bit on Saturday, a civil engineering report released by Surfside sparked questions. The 2018 overview from Morabito Consultants, part of a 40-year recertification process, found abundant cracking and spalling of varying degrees in concrete columns, beams, and walls supported with many pictures. It also cited concrete slabs underneath the pool deck showing distress and that should be removed and replaced in their entirety. Attorneys say Champlain Towers South had begun roof repairs and was about to address the other issues.
This is not unique in terms of having concrete problems. If there is an engineer who believes that concrete pitting and spalling and rebar deterioration poses a hazardous risk to the building and a risk of collapse, that needs to be clear. That needs to be in big, bold, red letters.
Do you agree with the assessment of the attorneys for the condo association that there were no red flags or signs of imminent collapse with that building?
We are obviously very interested in all of the evidence that's coming to light. And in the meantime, we're taking actions to make sure that other buildings are safe.
The South Building has two sister buildings. The North Tower is built in the same year, which officials say may be evacuated, and the East Tower, which is 13 years younger.
There's a crack in a column that was not here before the collapse.
Robert Lissman says this crack in the East Tower parking lot with debris below it has been determined structurally sound, and his building has taken steps to maintain safety. But he wants to know why engineers won't arrive here until next week.
They knew about a lot of the issues in the building for so long, and they allowed it to go and get past a point where it collapsed. I would like to prevent that.